Don't Book Smut Entertainment. And Nestle's Aerial. Politicians wish they had this much hot air in them. Give you Morrie Eel and his friend Shark. Yay! Oh, it's my favorite time of year again, Shark. It's Halloween! Oh, and all the decorations you get to put up, and I get to wear anything I want! Yay! Eddie, you already get to wear anything you want. You do? Oh, isn't that silly? Well, today, I'm dressed up as Ale! Ale, Ale! Oh, and what are you supposed to be, Shark?
I'm hanging my head in shame.
Oh, you're a ghost. Oh, and I see that Jenny has come dressed up as something, too. Jenny, what are you? Come here, come here.
I'm a slipper.
Oh, well, Shark actually has a brief little thing about people who make costumes at the last minute, giving you some great trick-or-treating advice. Come up.
Thank you, lad. Well, folks, I found that if you're in the business of making costumes at the last minute, make a practical Halloween costume. Your average pumpkin bucket fills up too fast and pillowcases are so boring. For this Halloween, go as your trick-or-treat bag. People will be practically throwing the candy at you. Back at you, lad.
Oh, thanks, Shark. I found a few other tips for you treaters out there. Always use a flashlight at night, because people are driving and you want them to see you, and you want to see where you're going. Even something as simple as a little ghost light can help you save the day and keep you from harm. Also, what I usually like to tell you is that when you're out trick-or-treating, be careful of the candies you get. I usually like to hand out apples and pencils and pennies, you know, practical things that kids can use, which means that kids don't always go to my house to trick-or-treat. But I have to warn you that there are still people out there who will give you nasty treats. So be sure that when your candy looks icky or if someone's house is all dark and shut up, you just stay away. Also remember to eat nice candies and nice pretty candy wrappers. Eat Mr. Good bars. Don't eat Mr. Good's bars. You don't know where Mr. Good's bars have been. Oh, and we have something very special for you. We'd like to introduce to you Zero! Hey, say hello, Zero. Oh, thank you so much, Zero. Oh, isn't it fun? It's a special Halloween. If you're at Disneyland, they're going to have the special Nightmare Before Christmas Haunted Mansion special. Isn't that right? How's Jack and Sally doing? Oh, that's so fun. How the kids? Oh, that's silly. Oh, and let me show us what you got here. Let's see, I'm going to bring these up. At Target, you can find these special items. These are the Nightmare Before Christmas collector set. Mm-hmm. There are 6 different figures in all of them. Well, thank you, Zero. And we also want to promote to you the special item that we've been working on. We have stickers. How fun. 6 little stickers. They cost $1.50 each, and it would help us so much if you bought some, because we're poor and everything's so tough in these times, but these stickers will make you happy. So please, give them and buy our stickers. So, it's been wonderful, and I hope you kids have a great Halloween. Shark, come up here for a moment. I have to ask, why did you get such a lame costume for the Halloween? You're going on and on about how, you know, people shouldn't make such lame costumes for Halloween in your little sketch. Well, I can't help it. That's just the way I am. I'm just a bit too sensitive for these types of shows. Well, you get over here. Take that thing off. Put on something more decent. What?
Let me out of here!
Nick, what's in there?
Man's a skeleton in this closet.
That's all right, Putney. He'll get used to you.
Spooks were having that midnight fling. The merry making was in full swing. They shrieked themselves to a cheerful dance. When the skeleton in the closet did his dance. Now goblin giggle with fiendish glee. A shout rang out from a big banshee. Amazing was every ghostly glance. When the skeleton in the closet started to dance.